Hello, and welcome to the Fender Experts for XDR video series. In this series, we aim to cover all aspects of the Fender Experts service, helping you understand the people behind the scenes who keep our customers safe from evolving cyber threats. In today's video, we have a special guest, our research lead, Brian. He'll be sharing insights into key research areas like threat intelligence, AI, and explain how he and his team work tirelessly to keep the Fender Expert customers secure. So without further ado, let's welcome Brian to this episode. Hello, Brian. Welcome, and we're glad to have you on with us today. How are you doing today, sir?
I'm doing very well, Edward and Sachin. Thank you so much for having me. I always love getting the chance to talk about the great work that we do every single day to help our customers.
That's great to hear, Brian. The pleasure is all ours. To start things off, can you tell a bit about how you got in the field of information security and cyber research?
Oh, it's a big question. Absolutely. So I started my career a number of years ago with Lockheed Martin. So for folks who don't know about Lockheed, very large U.S. defense contractor. And I think it was about 2007, I was working in a research and development portion of the company. I was working on systems administration, network engineering. And there was a brand new research and development project that came into the facility we were working on. And I had a good colleague of mine. He said, "Hey, Brian, have you heard about this project?" I said, "Well, yeah, I've heard about it. I don't know a lot about it, but I have heard about it." He said, "Hey, I think they could use your help." I thought, "Well, that sounds interesting. Yeah, let me go talk to them." It turns out they did need some help, but they were researching roots of trust. How do you establish a root of trust, especially and remember, this is 2007, especially when digital supply chain and physical supply chain were starting to become pretty significant issues. You can imagine that now, many years later, but at the time, this was pretty novel and pretty new for the industry. So I started working with them, and I, like I said, they needed help. So I started working full time with them. And that was when my toes got dipped into the water of information security. And I found it really connected a lot of the other things I did without maybe even realizing it. Elements of systems administration and understanding how computers worked and how network systems worked. And I've been doing it ever since. And at this point in my career, I cannot imagine doing anything else.
Brian, you're all soaked into cybersecurity. It's always fascinating to hear those stories and take a journey back with you in time, Brian. Now, could you tell us more about your current role in Microsoft Defender Experts for XDR team?
Yeah, I lead a team of researchers looking at what's next. And it really breaks down to three key areas. The first is service expansion, which really means looking at the Defender Experts services we deliver today to customers. Where are we headed next with them? How can we expand the scope of those services? Where do customers really need us and need our help? The second area is threat intelligence. I'm a huge believer of using threat intelligence to understand the context behind attacks. And when you understand the context, you're better prepared to defend and protect against them. And then the last area, this probably comes as no surprise to anyone, it's generative AI. It really is transformational in everything we do and everything we touch. So unlocking the power of that in our Defender Expert Services is a huge area of focus.
Thanks, Brian. With that, I have a question. We frequently talk about trillions of signals we synthesize and process. In practice, how does this help Microsoft to protect Defender Experts customers? Can you throw some light on this topic?
Yeah, this is one of my favorite questions because I have also seen the marketing materials. And I've talked with a lot of people who, you know, they kind of get a smirk on their face when they hear this phrase, these trillions of signals, you know, that their eyes roll a little bit. But for me and you know, especially my years at Microsoft, this is not just marketing. This is real. I see these signals behind the scenes every single day. My team sees these signals. We use these signals at Microsoft to protect our customers. And this is true. This does really happen every single day. And this is really one of our kind of superpowers, if you want to think of it that way. It's this ability to see things going on across the globe, to capture information about these, to capture these as signals, and then turn those signals into knowledge, turn that knowledge into protection for our customers. And it really does help us stay ahead of the attackers. And the biggest reason why is when an attacker attacks someone across the globe and it generates those signals, we can see those, we can understand them, we can deeply investigate them, and we can provide protection across the suite of everything Microsoft delivers so that all customers benefit. It's kind of that whole rising tide lifts all ships mentality. Mm-hmm. And mm-hmm. when we as Defender experts do this, we're kind of that tip of the spear, and we see those attacks right when they happen. We protect those customers in the moment, but then we help all other customers get protected by working with other parts of the company.
Wow, that sounds super important, Brian, and I understand it's a critical role that you play and your team plays. So thank you for that. Thank you for sharing that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, on top of it, Brian, for the benefit of our audience, can you give us some more examples of the type of threats you come across and how you collaborate with other stakeholders?
Sure. This is also a really good question because so much of the benefits we offer to customers is through that internal collaboration. Now, customers don't necessarily see this, and we try very hard so they don't see all these different teams that we have inside the company that are helping them be safe every single day. But behind the scenes, this is really critical. One great example of how this plays out is with phishing. Now, I think everyone, certainly the two of you, absolutely your audience, they understand phishing and why it is such a severe attack, because it starts pretty simple most of the times, but it is by far the biggest delivery vector of threats that customers face. And when the attack starts to unfold, you can kind of imagine us being that tip of the spear and how this could play out. So we see these kind of phishing attacks start to unfold. We see some of the techniques that they're using. We can provide defenses and protections to keep our Defender experts safe immediately. But then behind the scenes, we'll work with the brilliant researchers, the brilliant security practitioners in the other parts of the company, including Defender for Office. We can say, hey, MDO team, we're starting to see this new campaign over here. It's like this one, but there's these variants. It causes some evasion. And then this is how the attack unfolds. Here's all the details of what we see. Now, we know this because we're protecting our Defender experts customers who are facing these attacks. Defender for Office is trying to protect the globe. And yeah. So they don't always zoom in on any one individual nuance or specific attack against a specific customer. But from our vantage point, this is really important to protect every single Defender Experts customer we have. So we're able to capture those details, package it up in a way that Defender for Office can really take it, and then provide durable protection for all other customers. Internally, we use this term flywheel. This is kind of the flywheel of attack to understanding, understanding to protection for a Defender Experts customer, understanding the attack and the techniques, sharing those with our other teams. They provide durable protection across the entire Defender for Office suite. All customers start getting the benefit. And you can see this wheel happening over and over and over again every day. It truly does happen that fast. One other team that gets involved, and there are many of these teams, but one other team that often gets involved, I talked earlier about threat intelligence and threat intelligence context. We work so closely with the Microsoft Threat Intelligence Center that I kind of take it for granted how much they benefit us, and then how much those techniques that we are seeing bubbles intelligence back their way. So then they get a better understanding of not just the attack, but who could be behind this attack. they build up our knowledge or our corpus of knowledge about those attackers, and then they can fuel that back into all the other products as well. So customers don't just have protection from things like Defender for Office, they also have context about the why behind the attack.
Very cool. Thank you for sharing that, Brian. And thank you for the explanation on the flywheel aspect. That helps me understand the totality of the protection that the Microsoft products do, but also the human-led services, particularly your team. And it's clear that what you do is sort of the linchpin, right? You can't rely on technology exclusively. You need human interaction and aspect of it. So, and this sounds like that's what keeping the defender experts up, you know, ahead of the curve with these attackers. So thank you for sharing that.
Absolutely.
Brian, thanks, Brian. That was a deep dive tour of TI and your role in Defender Experts team. And that brings us to the end of today's episode. We hope you found this discussion insightful and gained a good understanding of our role of our research team in Defender Experts service. We'll be back soon with another episode and with another special guest. Until then, stay safe and stay vigilant.
Absolutely. Stay safe, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, Edward.
Yes.